Okay, guys, I really want to work another radical equation for you. These can be a little bit tricky because we have quite a few steps we need to go through. All right, so notice on this problem how we have this radical with a plus 3. The first part of the recipe is to get that radical by itself. So we need to move the plus 3 to the other side, and we are going to do this by subtraction. So my first step is to write the square root of x plus 3 equals x minus 3. All right. Now, in the recipe, it says to square both sides. So I grab my radical side, I square it, and I grab the entire right side and square it. Again, note I grabbed the whole side. I did not simply grab the x or the 3, but instead I put the whole side in parentheses. All right. On the left side here, what does this mean in terms of the square and the square root? Well, they undo each other. This is why we are using the square, all right, to get rid of the radical. And then on the right side, what I'm going to do is I'm going to write these parentheses twice. Now, why do I do that? Because that tells my brain, hey, I need to FOIL this right side. And so I begin to FOIL x squared minus 3x minus 3x plus 9. All right, and one more step here to simplify the right side because I can combine those two negative 3x's. All right, so what do I want to do at this point? I need to ask myself, do I have a quadratic equation or do I have a linear equation? Well, because I have this term right here, I know that it's quadratic. And so what that means is I need to move everything to one side. All right, and I'm going to do this by subtracting an x, right? So I'm going to minus an x, which gives me the minus 7x, and I'm going to minus 3 here to get a plus 6. Many of you at this point are going to use the quadratic formula, negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. That is certainly fine. As I look at this, though, I notice that I can factor it into linear factors, and I'm going to go ahead and do that. All right, and then I'm going to set each factor equal to 0, and I'm going to solve for x. And so I get two solutions, x equals 6 and x equals 1. All right, do I jump up and down and smile and clap because I have my answer? No, not yet. Okay, recall our original problem, okay? All right, this is our original problem. I need to plug the 6 and the 1 in for x to see if it actually works. All right, and so when I plug in the 6, I need to know, is this true? All right, and so I get the square root of 9 plus 3 equals 6. Is this true? Well, the square root of 9 is 3. I get 3 plus 3. And that definitely equals 6. All right, so 6 is definitely a solution. All right, let's try 1. All right, I get the square root of 1 plus 3 plus 3 equals 1. Oh, yep. And what do I have here? I don't know what I was doing there. Let's go back for a second. I said 3 and wrote a 4. I guess my brain was going to go ahead and try to do the math for you. All right, so where are we? We have the square root of 4 plus 3. Does this equal 1? Well, square root of 4 is 2. I'm sure you guys love that. All right, and 2 plus 3, does that equal 1? Well, heck no, it doesn't. All right, so 1 is not a solution. And so all we're going to type in for our answer is x plus 6.